Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I make a lot of videos about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about how to create a dashboard filter and what you can do with dashboard filters. So I'm currently on a dashboard. I have downloaded a package from Salesforce that has a bunch of user adoption reports and dashboards, so that's what you're seeing right now. I did not build this. Other things is that I have created a dashboard filter, and we can go over that in a little bit, and how to create one for yourself. But let's talk about the differences between a dashboard filter and a running user. So two very important distinctions that I have gotten confused in the past. A dashboard filter allows you to narrow down your dashboard and view it from different angles of criteria. So right now we have it where the last modified date could be equal to the last fiscal quarter, which has no data. Or we could change it to the last modified date is equal to April Fool's, or the 1st of April. If we go back up, we can select all. So these are both criteria-based things that we have set up, and that is what a dashboard filter does. It's criteria-based. Whereas filtering it by a running user allows us to see the dashboard how they would see it, and how, or based upon their security and their level in the hierarchy of the role hierarchy, how they would see it. So let's take this example for a dashboard running user. Let's say you are the VP of sales, and underneath you in the role hierarchy, you have the Western Sales District, the Eastern Sales District, and the International Sales District. You could set up a running user dashboard to view it as the director of international sales, or the director of Eastern sales, or the director of Western sales, and see it how they would see the dashboard rather than how you would see it. So those are the differences between running users and dashboard filters. Filters are based upon a certain set of criteria, and running user is based upon the person that you want to view it as. So let's go ahead and hit edit here and add a filter. And here we can use criteria to change it. So I'm going to have this next one be the created date, and the filter will display as created date. We can change this if we wanted to. And then we can also add a filter value. We can have this be equals, not equal to, greater than, less than, between, whatever you'd like. I'm going to keep it as equals because that's the one I find the most relevant. We can have this be a calendar date. So if we wanted to see it created on a certain day when we uploaded a lot of, or we inserted a lot of opportunities, then we'd be able to do that. I'm going to hit relative and have this be created date was last fiscal quarter. There we go. I'm going to hit apply, and we have one filter value. We can add more filter values, and this could be equal to, I could have this be this fiscal quarter. Now this may not run. It might have to be current fiscal quarter. Let's go ahead and hit add. And as you can see, we do have the created date filter next to the last modified one, which I previously created. We cannot view it while it's in the edit mode, so we have to save and then hit done after it saves to be able to test this out. So if we wanted to change the created date and filter it down by created by the last fiscal quarter, there we go. It is able to do that. And there's no data because this is a Trailhead org and we don't have much data in here. We can change it to this fiscal quarter, and as you can see, we do actually have data for this fiscal quarter. I can change it back to all, and if we wanted to, we could do this fiscal quarter plus the last modified date was April Fool's, which does not bring up much data for us. So I hope that you found this helpful and to kind of explain the differences between running users and dashboard filters, as well as how to create a dashboard filter and kind of what the rules are about it. So If you found this helpful, be sure to give this video a like, subscribe, comment if you have any questions. Check out the courses down below that I have on all the different things about Salesforce. And thank you so much for joining me. I'll catch you in the next one.